All the best. Thank you.
I'll just one question, sorry, the whole place, nobody would interview, but you are from Fulton, huh?
Yes.
How far is from Y? Y, Y?
Y, yes.
You have been there?
I haven't been there, sir.
You never been to your workplace?
I've been to workplace, not in Y.
Y, okay. Have you heard any gentleman with Hindu on bark?
I'm sorry.
Okay, okay.
Yes, it's good that you have heard.
May I come in, sir?
Come in.
Good afternoon, sir, good afternoon, ma'am.
Good afternoon, sit down, please.
Thank you, sir. Thank you, sir.
Tell us how you learnt from your previous attempts at civil service.
Yes. So my first attempt, I did not take it much seriously, as I was not aware that I would clear the prelims. So the approach was a little casual, but the second attempt was pretty serious, and I lost out in the essay marks. But this time I overcame that, and I cleared the mains.
What happened third time around?
So third time around, I did a lot of practice regarding essay writing and also answer writing, and I got it checked.
So the learning process means you improved upon essay, right?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Essay plus all other areas also. Because my commerce course was also not very good. It was 250 marks, but I think this time I have improved it.
Those are your basic degrees?
Yes, sir.
How come you didn't score them?
So I used to write my answers according to the topic that was asked, not according to the questions. But this time I overcame that and I framed my answers according to the questions that were asked.
What is the concept of performance audit?
So performance audit is basically an audit which the audit is done for performance, not for the finance, as the audit especially that is usually done. So we come to know what are the how the performance is taken place, whether it is good or whatever we have whatever was asked has been done or not. Right. So it is a better preparation or better way over financial audit.
I am given to understand that in present system of costing,
yes,
the work done by housewife at home is not taken into consideration.
Yes, calculating the GDP of India, the work done by housewives is not taken into consideration.
Analyze it. How come? Is that right? Is it fair?
Sir, it is not fair because they contribute a significant portion to the GDP. And actually, there was an analysis which said that the most job losses that have happened during this recession is because of women. That has happened. So, in fact, that should be taken into consideration while calculating the GDP of India.
Day before yesterday, I heard a word that like there is housewife, there should also be house husbands.
So, this is the new gender change of roles that has been happening, because right now it is like females also altogether at par with males. So, because the job profile right now has changed, so a lot of BPOs coming up, and that has changed the job profile also. Yeah.
But the very mention of house husband, why does it make you smile?
Sir, because India has been a male dominated country, I am sorry to say that, but it has been that. So, gender change or change of role, gender, not gender change, I am sorry for that, but it usually makes one smile.
Who was Milton Friedman?
So, Milton Friedman was an economist. I only know that much about him. Much. I have not read
nothing about his theory.
No, sir. I have not
actually
read
much. The whole present process of recession relates to this economic theory.
Sir, I have not read much about Milton Friedman.
Alan Greenspan.
Yes, sir. He was a former governor of Federal Reserve Bank of USA, and he propagated more of opening up of more of capitalism, less of government interference, and that has led to the downfall of U.S. economy.
And he confessed.
Yes, sir. So he was an ardent devotee or ardent fan of Atlas Shrugged, Ayn Rand's Atlas Shrugged, and that is one of the books which said that government should have less interference. So he confessed that things have gone wrong.
Will Obama's bailout package work?
Sir, it depends on where he spends the bailout package. Because right now giving bailout for spending for only auto giants will not help the entire US economy. It is the buying of the bad mortgage assets that is also to take place. If that takes place, the US economy will be out of the shock that it is in, and the bad assets, the mortgages, will be purchased. So I think
his policy is anti-India.
Yes, sir. He has anti-India policies basically, because he is saying do not buy from abroad, buy within the country, domestic economy.
Under WTO charter, can he do that?
So he cannot do that. That is protectionism, and that is why we have lodged a formal complaint with WTO regarding it.
Will it hamper the normalization of Indo-US relationship?
It will certainly to some degree hamper the normalization of relationship. But in WTO, it has always been a star relationship between India and USA. We have always been against USA in WTO.
Obama's policy is anti-India. Are they anti-India or pro-American?
Sir, they are to bring America out of the recession. It is not anti-India.
So the statesman,
yes,
of the nation, what should be his priority?
Sir, his priority should be definitely concentrating on the USA. But that should not be largely at the stake of other countries.
Why did this happen in USA? Suddenly, in the month of September, everything was happening. Isn't it 2008? And suddenly this bubble busted in the... What happened overnight?
Sir, the subprime loans that were given.
Have been going on for years together.
Sir, for 2 years, but the effect was not that prominent, and the how many banks have invested in subprime loans was not very clear. But after September 2008, suddenly new institutions have come up, which are showing increased losses or increased sustenance, increased like exposure to these investments.
Who blew the whistle for this so-called meltdown in the USA? Who are the instrumental?
So the investment banks especially were instrumental, and Lehman Brothers especially started the thing.
So what is sustainable development mean?
So sustainable development means using the resources without compromising the resources of the future generation that is yet to come.
The way we are going for development process in India, will we be able to sustain this?
No sir, definitely.
Then what should we be doing?
So usage of resources should be according to what we need right now. That should be the correct strategy, and basically care for the environment, and it should be accordingly. Currently we are not doing that.
Coming from this word environment you use, and you also use the word GDP.
Yes, sir.
But the entire world is using the word GDP. Is there any country, are there any country in the world which use the word GNH, Gross National Happiness?
Yes, sir. It is Bhutan.
And anybody else?
Sir, I'm not too sure, but...
What does this indicate?
So it indicates how happy the people there are. That is what it is.
So what should be more important, the GDP or the GNH?
So currently it is the GNH which should be more probably more important.
Right. Then you mentioned about the ladies gender wise.
I just want to drop one question in between.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Please. Is GDP and GNH necessarily contradictory to each other? Is it inversely proportional?
Sorry sir, I do not understand the relation. But I think that more of GDP can lead to some amount of happiness, because economics can work that way.
What forced King of Bhutan to adopt the philosophy of GNH as opposed to GDP?
So the natural resources in Bhutan and the usage of those.
What is the population of Bhutan?
I'm not sure.
A million? Less than a million, roughly? Okay. One more thing, question. When were the ladies allowed to vote first time in Italy? Any idea?
No, sir.
USA?
No, sir.
Was it in 43,
44? Yes, sir. It was definitely during that.
So are we better off than them, or they are better?
Yes, sir. We are definitely better off.
You have public administration as your subject. You must have learned about the principles of administration.
Yes, ma'am.
Which among them is the most important
according
to your administration?
Ma'am, unity of command is most important for me. Unity of command is probably the most important.
Why is that?
Ma'am, because it is like following two bosses becomes all the more difficult for a subordinate. So unity of command says that you should only have one person who will be in charge. That will make decision making fast, and that will fasten up the process. So according to me, it is unity of command that is more important, right?
What do you think is the difference in administration in the government and in private sector?
Ma'am, the focus is altogether different, basically. In private sector, the focus is only on profit making, but government is more service oriented.
Is it?
Yes, ma'am. It is not only profit that the government is after, it is also service. Private sector is not only worried about it is not in fact worried about the service. It is more in fact worried about the profit model.
Thank you.
and the hierarchy or the accountability is also different. Private sector right now does not have as much accountability as the government has. It is government has accountability to the public citizens, but private sector right now is only accountable to its customers, not more than.
What is the image of the government in the eyes of the common man?
It is, for India especially, it is the savior. The government is the whole and soul for the common man in India. It can do a lot of policies, it can frame, it can do a lot of work for the common people. That is what the image of common man is in for the government.
It can do.
It does.
What is the actual real image of that?
Ma'am, as far as this current government is concerned, I would like to interpret your question in that way. It has not done accordingly what it should have done. Regarding the inflation or the policies that it has been posting for the past 5 years, it has not done accordingly what it should have done.
Should the system of recruitment that UPSC follows be changed?
So the Administrative Reforms Commission has hinted at that, second the report of ARC. Basically, I feel that it should be a mixture. Not only reducing the age limit is not the answer to that, because in rural areas still there are people who by the time know about UPSC, their ages are around 22, 23, 24, 25. So, and they have given a limit of 26 years, 24, 25, and attempts also less. So I don't think so. It will be a gross like injustice to those people.
How about optional subjects?
So they have said that optional should be scrapped. So I don't think so that optionals should be scrapped. I think including a personality test will do more benefit to UPSC, because it is a mind frame that has to be tested rather than the subject's knowledge.
Actually, can character and integrity be tested in say 30 minutes or by any test? Is there any test?
So psychology has definitely evolved some test in the current scenario where integrity, honesty and such things can be tested. So it has reached there.
Can you beat a lie detector test?
Yes, sir. Definitely, so, some people can.
So, like there are coaching classes now.
Yes, sir.
I'm sure there will be coaching classes for beating all these tests and appearing for 30 minutes as if you are next to Gandhiji in character.
Yes, sir. Definitely, there will be. But I think so. The psychology of person, it cannot be changed ultimately. I think some other point of time it will come out, and then the recommendation of ARC do make sense that after 12 years of review or 15 years of review, he can be relieved of service.
What should sway more, character or integrity?
It's actually both, because it is integrity which makes character.
I may have character, but I am not, in your sense, maybe not be. My integrity may be doubt or suspect.
Yes, sir.
Or I may be very loyal to you.
Yes,
but my character may be suspect.
Yes, sir. So I think both of them are required. It is not all at the cost of other.
So for the Indian Institute of Services,
yes,
what is more important?
So I would still hold my view that character with integrity is the most important point.
Flowing from this, you know, the school of thought,
yes,
like you know your views, like in the armed forces, they put boys from NDA,
yes,
class 12 onwards, groom them, train them, and put them in different services. There is a thought process in the Administrative Reform Commission, but right from after plus 2, they should be tuned. Like the Forest Service in China, will this model work in India? Is it desirable or not? Will it work or not?
Sir, it is desirable. But I would, my suggestion is not all recruitment should happen through that way. It is like in defense, we have the IMA also, like for postgraduates. Like they also become officers later on. And the cadet culture that is there of India. So the same process if we have in civil services, it will definitely do good to the civil services in India.
Define integrity.
So may I use a story to define integrity? Sure. Integrity cannot be defined, because I heard a story through which I came to know about integrity more.
There is a definition of integrity given by Azad Mohammed.
So I am not aware of integrity.
Yes.
So integrity is to be felt, not I cannot define it personally.
What Mohammed says is this: integrity is that commitment to a code of ethics,
yes,
not necessarily the Muslim code of ethics,
yes,
to any code of ethics, even when your self-interest is at stake.
That's you said right. You said integrity is to be felt.
Yes, sir.
Is it same as love or poetry?
Sir, I said integrity one should have within rather than felt, or it is like one which one it should have within one person should have it within rather than one cannot have it outside. So I feel that it is more internal feeling rather than outward display.
So you read spiritual literature.
Yes.
What kind of spiritual literature do you read?
So my favorite author in spiritual books is Neil Donald Walsh, and he has written Conversations with God. And I like poetry by Kalil Gibran also.
So what does Kalil Gibran tell about marriage?
Yes, sir. So he says that the couples should be, they should be one, but they should not at the same time be so close to each other. It should be distinguishable from one pillar to other. So that is what essence is. So like they should have love, but it should not be so much that they are so close that it begins to feel become a trouble for them.
Drink together but not from the same
tea. Same tea, yes.
Is it really right that God dictated the book to Neil Donald Walsh?
Sir, as far as I would comment on that, it doesn't make a difference whether God dictated or whether he played through his imagination. It is one and the same thing. He could as well.
Okay, but he claims so.
Sir, but in the book he has said that it doesn't make a difference whether God dictated it to him or whether he played it through his own imagination, because that is what my answer would be also. Like,
when he says God dictated the book through him, is he fictionalizing the experience, or does he really mean God dictated through him?
So this form of writing is known as magic writing, basically, and. In the past also, like, there have been prophets or there have been messengers of God who have used this form. Prophet Muhammad is a good enough example, and also Moses, for example.
How do you separate between God's message and hallucination?
Sir, hallucination, actually, sir, maybe God could as well work through hallucination rather than anything else. So I don't think so. Maybe it can be a hallucination, but if the person gets a view of what his true self is, so I think that is much more important than what God would see there.
Mr. Richard Dawkins says God, the very idea of God itself is hallucination.
Sir, as I said, I would still say that it doesn't make a difference whether God is there or not. Basically, it is if you are there, God is there. That is what I would hold.
You said personality does not, type does not change.
Yes, sir.
That's what Western psychology and Jung says. But Vipassana,
yes,
claims that personality can be changed. And it's empirically recorded that the Jung psychology, the type changes through Vipassana. So what do you have to comment about that?
Sir, but it would be in a very long time to, it would not be in a short run that it can take place. But definitely I would agree that Vipassana and yogic practices would help a person's personality to change, because
they claim that it changes in 10 days.
Yes, sir. I have seen some people doing Vipassana and their entire focus has changed, or they have felt things much deeper than they were doing that. But it was, in fact, they can do that and they are claiming. But I think that these kind of practices, if they are practiced more, can help. But for a person to suddenly change overnight is very difficult in that kind.
What is your most favorite movie?
So in the past year, I would say that The Dark Knight is my most favorite.
Man, the one who loves spiritualism,
yes,
how can you have Dark Knight at number one?
Sir, the character of Joker that is played in that movie especially represents the current scenario that we are facing, the world is facing, terrorism especially.
Is it a sympathy way for Heath Ledger's death?
No sir, definitely not. Definitely not.
How did he die?
Sir, drug overdose.
Is that a common thing with Hollywood guys?
Yes, sir.
Any other examples?
Sir, right now I'm not remembering any names.
There I can't figure out, you see so many movies,
yes,
and suddenly Dark Knight at number one.
Sir, this is for the past year.
No, I'm saying all time greats. Among all time greats, your movie number one.
Sir, it will be that Matrix movies.
One, two, three?
Yes, sir.
All three?
Yes.
All three together?
Yes, all
why? Right.
So they have a spiritual message. That is why what I liked about it.
What is the spiritual message of it?
So it teaches to believe in oneself. It is like if you are the one, you can do anything. That is what the ultimate objective of life is.
Is it actually Shankaracharya's Mayavad?
Yes, sir. Illusion. They have said about. They have talked about illusion.
What kind of music do you like?
So I listen to all kinds of music, but my interest is like it depends basically on the mood. Maybe it is hard rock is also as I like it as good as soft.
You like Himesh Reshmiya?
No, sir.
Mika?
No, sir.
So you never have a mood where you like Himesh Reshmiya and Mika?
No, sir. That is like sir Hindi music I don't listen to much. Maybe I listen to much of instrumental. Enigma is my favorite instrumental band.
Is there a correlation between illusion, hallucination, and mirage?
Have yes.
You heard of mirage?
Yes.
Please, mirage.
Sir, in the desert, this happens.
Is there any other mirage also?
Sir, the aircraft mirage.
Sorry?
Aircraft.
Okay. So let's talk about desert mirage.
Yes, sir. So it happens when the because of the heat, the upper layer being. I am not too good in geography.
No.
Allow me to guess. The upper layer being cool and the lower layer being hot, that creates a wave and that you see things there which are not there.
What is hallucination then?
Sir, I'm not too sure about hallucination.
Then what is illusion?
Sir, illusion. Yes, sir, illusion. Like you see the thing, but it cannot. It may not be the same thing as you're seeing it. Or maybe thing is happening, but there is some background to it, or you have to go and get behind the scenes.
Finally, so flowing from this.
Yes, sir.
Who created God? God himself or the man created God?
Sir, I would like to refer to like in quantum physics also it is said that it is all that was there. It is all that will be there and that is there. So it is like the same form of energy that was there and that will still be there. So I consider it that it cannot be destroyed nor can it be created. So I would point.
You refer to quantum physics. Yes. In quantum physics they say observation affects the
yes.
The act of observing affects your observation.
Yes.
So do you think actually Samuel Huntington's thesis has produced the kind of world that he imagined?
Sir, right now there are books which have been written, brilliant books, which say that whatever you think about, you attract to that. There is this law of attraction which says that. So definitely what one person thinks he will be able to attract, he can create that. I would certainly offer that.
So Samuel Huntington has created the Clash of Civilizations.
Sir, I have not read Samuel Huntington, but I have only read his book, name of the book, but I have not researched much into Samuel Huntington. I won't be able to comment on that.
I have one question.
Sure, go ahead.
I have a strange hobby watching Formula One.
Yes, go
ahead. To me that indicates, is there a streak of recklessness or something in your personality? Why does this attract?
No one, actually. In fact, if you one watches Formula One, this is like at great speed that they are moving, 350 kilometers per hour, and at that speed they have to control the car, and it is the man behind the machine which controls it. So I think it is more of control rather than speed. It is not recklessness; it is controlled driving that is playing.
What is? Why do you get attracted to this?
The concept of team spirit that is played in Formula One is absolutely brilliant. Within 6 seconds, they change the entire car. They change the tires. They fill up the car, and it is back. So one person, if he makes a mistake, the team loses. So I think that team spirit is very important. So I like it because of that. Because it is a blink of an eye, in 6 seconds you cannot lose something.
On joining civil service, your seniors or politicians pressurize you to make a fast work for them. How would you tackle these issues?
So I would not work under any conditions.
What does it mean? They'll track you actually. They'll corner you. They'll issue a memo. They'll destroy your CR.
So I'm not concerned about the CR. I will do my best work.
And they will transfer you to some remote place.
The transfer is a part of this job. I'm ready for it.
What kind of wife do you want?
Sir, I've not thought about it until yet.
Is it not high time?
I don't think so. My first priority is always IS, UPSC.
So whenever do you intend to get married?
Yes, sir.
Are you going to relegate your wife to secondary position?
So that will be the first priority after I join services. Not now.
Getting married because the dowry rates go up.
No, sir, definitely not. Definitely not.
while waiting for clearing exam?
So, this will be like marriage is also like I would want to stand on my own feet rather than depending on any other my parents and others.
See, all these practical answers are all okay.
Yes.
But every boy or even a girl,
yes,
have idea about their spouse.
Yes.
That's what I'm asking. What are your ideas about spouse?
Sir, seriously, I have not given a thought about it right now.
This cannot happen. Are you a normal human being?
Yes, sir.
And with so many movies you watch, suddenly you think a spouse like Sharon Stone. It's just not possible.
So Sharon Stone is good on screen, but
yeah,
not as a spouse.
How do you know that?
So I have seen the movies.
So, oh, you can judge only about movies.
Yes.
How do you know that off screen, as a spouse, she's not good?
Maybe the amount, the number of husbands that she has had. That says
how
all.
How many husbands she has?
So I think 3. I'm not too sure about that, but I think it is 3.
I know that Friends is one of your favorite series.
Yes, sir.
So even Ross was married 3 times.
So it is in the serial, not in the real life.
But does it make him a bad husband?
So but it makes him a funny husband, not a bad.
Who will make a good prime minister for India?
So the picture right now is not very clear, but I think the prime minister, like Narendra Modi, with minus the Hindutva ideology, with the development agenda, will definitely do India.
Is the existence and increasing strength of regional parties,
yes,
detrimental to national integrity?
It is actually, sir, detrimental because the number of national parties that are participating in elections has gone up. 2004 it was 17, and we saw a huge pull of the central government to manage those affairs. Right now it is 45 parties that are participating in the elections this year. So that will definitely affect the integrity of the government.
Actually, no, we are not discussing integrity of the government.
Yes, sir.
We are discussing integrity of the nation. So are TDP, AGP, DMK, are they anti-national?
So some of the policies, as we saw in the last coalition, are not for the development of India. Especially the Indo-US nuclear deal can be cited as an example. This was the left government which was opposing it without considering the benefits of what it can provide.
So, but in the near future, I don't see any single party emerging,
yes,
capable of garnering clear majority on its own.
Sir, but there is a process, like they can have a common minimum program on which they agree to coordinate. That will be a kind of one program which the people will also know and which the, from which the people will elect the party to power. So I think the responsibility is on the parties to form alliance and come out with a common minimum program. Even Israel for that matter never has a coalition since its beginning, but it has
never has a coalition.
So
always has a coalition.
Always has a coalition. Always.
What is India's GDP tax ratio?
So right now it is 12.5%.
What should it be?
So approximately it should be 17%.
What are the plans to do?
So simplification of taxes, rationalization of taxes, widening of the tax base should be the basic idea.
Will it not increase tax burden on people?
No sir, if the tax base is widened, the rates will come down. So the burden ultimately will not increase on people. It will, in fact, for the common one it will reduce, but the volume will fetch more taxes.
Where is Marathi Sahitya Sammelan?